Warming the tractor up. Got the blade, got the trailer. Got some saws, safety equipment. Getting ready to go out in the woods. Supposed to get up to 25 today. So we'll see how that goes. Only a slight breeze. Well, I loaded up a few of those maple rounds and a little bit of birch. Came around the corner and got a limb that came right off of that ash tree. So before I can take the tractor up to the next stop, I have to get the chainsaws out and do a little clearing. Well, 10 minutes later, the path is cleared. I got a few saw logs or firewood sticks out of there. And the deer have a nice little brush pile to hide. Up the hill we go. Well, I haven't really done much. Cut up that one little limb. But here's some oak. Red oak that I split off the main trunk. That was from 2 years ago. Check and see if it's seasoned up yet in the big blocks. Probably have to split it a little smaller yet. Just so you get a little idea how big it is. Comes up to my hip. Oh, I found a tape measure in with my gear. That's measuring on the low side. Probably got another 3 or 4 inches. Brakes off right at 27, 27 and a half. Let's see if I can get around here. It's sunk in a little bit. Hello. 32 and a half, 33. So that was a good size tree. And you can see the stump of it right up here. I've got some more splits that I've stacked up on top and around the stump. Cut two actual pieces off of it. And these are 16 inches, so it's a few inches shy here and another 8 inches there. This one was a little smaller. It came down first. We just sent it right down that way and then chopped it up and carried it out. And this is what's left of the second one. I've got several rounds here that are pretty big. I gotta get the splitter out here. Vertical mode. Those are above my knee. Got four of them still and a few smaller diameter, but this mid thigh high right there. And then on up. I'd like to get that ash tree out from underneath it, or at least a couple logs off of it. Drag them up to the wood yard. Kind of was afraid when I was dropping the big side of that red oak. I got this ash down and it got hung up on the stump and it fell right this way. But when the red oak came down, landed on top of it and knocked it off. I took down this ironwood too, just so nothing would get caught. I imagine the weight of this thing probably would have taken them out anyway, but there's still a lot of good oak all down through there that I gotta get after and get split. Then got another ash tree right over here. It was dead standing. And I dropped it off. Lots of deer markings. Those paths are just crowded with deer trail. So I'd like to drag this one out of here too. I think that is a white oak. White oak right out there on the arch. But that's over on the neighbor's property, so I'm not going to mess with that one. My line is about a foot past that stump going off to the right. You can see a marker flag on it. But a lot of poplar up in through here. That's just going to take its way, but I don't know if you can see with the clouds and sun, but that's a nice ash. With the ash borer, it's going to be dead soon. And another one right next to it. I'd like to drop those right where this oak is once I get the oak all out of the way. So plenty to do. Back when this came down and we split it, I put a couple pieces of limb down underneath so it wouldn't freeze to the ground when the snow and water came. Worked out pretty good when I got down to there. Just a light little kick broke the freeze on it. So next, the 311, we'll take it over here and cut this ash log off. I'll go back, dump the trailer, and then bring the tractor back up, see if I can drag that out today. Thank you. Well, we got the trailer pulled out of the woods. Got a bunch of miscellaneous wood I want to test moisture content on. We'll get some splitting done. And so for the winter, I like to put the splitter here in the garage. I've got a big barn door that slides open on both sides. And then I've got a cross breeze coming from the man door. So we get some ventilation, but it keeps the big wind out. And on a day when it's 25 degrees, that makes it a little more comfortable. Okay, we get the moisture meter fired up, got it warmed up. This is the red oak. So around 6%. This is the ironwood. Five or 6%. And this is the small maple tree. 17.6. So it should all be good. Should all be good to burn in the fireplace. So we'll keep splitting.